Game of Thrones Enhanced version 5.5. Alright, so I thought it was very stable because in the past, I believe in November or something, or early December 2020, I let the AI play for over 1000 turns and it didn't crash to desktop. I got a new version from Firestorm on December 8th, and that version has been improved. I worked on it before uploading it on modibe.com. But the problem is that the game would crash on turn 31. I suspected that it was because of a script. There are spawns for the Wildlings, the Night's Watch, and not the White Night's Watch, but the Wildlings, the others, the House Targaryen, and it seemed that on turn 30 to 31, Daryon Harris of the Targaryen faction would spawn with an army of, I believe, he has Second Sons, and he has Golden Company, and I believe the Golden Company Knights, as they were named in the older version of the mod, the one that I worked on. That version has some units with different names. It's the same unit, but Firestorm may have changed the names. So I thought the name was still the same, so I just moved over the same line from that version to the other version, because it's the same map, it's the same like mod. It's just that I believe Firestorm he started from scratch, while the version I worked on was the old version, but P-Man had moved over Solgamis Inkel's map to it. So I had the old version, and then P-Man replaced the old map with a new map, forcing me to re-add everything onto the map, while Firestorm, he made a sub-mod where he, I believe, replaced a completely different mod's map. I believe it was another mod that he used as a base, and then he removed that map and added Solgamis Inkel's map. And that mod was a better base, it was more stable and such. And then he replaced everything in it to make it like Game of Thrones Enhanced, adding many of the scripts from Game of Thrones Enhanced and such. But he made his own alterations to the map and to the units. He didn't like that the original Game of Thrones Enhanced had a lot of clones with different weapons. The units looked the same, they had the same bodies, but they had different weapons, so he he made more unique variations. He removed a lot of the clones and made the ones he kept different by editing them and changing their textures and maybe moving gear around and such. The point is that some units that were in the old version were kept, but they were renamed. So Daryon Harris spawns with an army of Second Sons and Golden Company for House Targaryen, and he spawns on turn 31, and the game will crash because the Golden Company Knights are no longer named Knights, but I had written Golden Company Knights in the scripts file. Of course I fixed that now, so it's corrected. So I'm about to upload a new version, an updated version where that mistake has been corrected. But I want to check that there are no other mistakes. So we will let AI play for about 200 turns, because the last script, I believe, happens at about turn 70 something. But I want to be sure. I don't want players to crash, so I need to check that it works, and that's why we are going to let the AI control the others, you'll have a toggle FOV on, so you can see the entire map. Also, we are following AI characters, so we will be able to see I see the mic sound is also lowered. When I lower the music, I also lower my own voice, because I thought I spoke very, how should I say, I almost didn't hear myself. Alright, okay, fuck. Hello, Mr. Nygren here. This is Game of Thrones version 5.5. I did a mistake when I worked on the mod yesterday. You see, I tested this mod, I playtested it in November and December, and it went on for over 800 to 1000 turns without a crash on the map, so it shouldn't crash. But the day between, I believe, Sunday to Monday or something, I believe that was yesterday, I worked on it for many hours, and I added some spawns and such. The problem is that there existed two versions of the mod. The original version of Game of Thrones Enhanced existed, of course, and that's the one I worked on. P-Man helped me with moving over Soul Games Inkle's map to the old version, replacing the small map that used to be in the mod. And then I had to re-add everything to the map and such, and then when that was done, I had to add new units and such from Fire and Blood and such. But that map, that version wasn't very good, because it still had a bug that you needed to play a custom battle first before entering the campaign, etc. Otherwise it would crash to desktop. And also it wasn't good because you couldn't add any new scripts. All the old scripts worked perfectly, but you couldn't add anything new. And we needed a version where you could add new scripts. And then Firestorm, he had used a different Game of Thrones mod as a base. And then he had replaced everything in it, the map, the art, everything. So that it became a clone of Game of Thrones Enhanced, and the difference was that you didn't need to start a custom battle first before entering the campaign, and you could add new scripts, so it was better, and that's why we decided to use it instead of the old version as the new version of the mod. But when we moved to his version, he had already added everything to his map, including the three cities of Essos and the others, two factions I hadn't yet been able to add. I had added pretty much everything else but to the old version, but not the three cities and not the others. And also I believe that Firestorm did a lot of heroes, so of course I believe I added all his heroes from October and November to the old version, but not the ones from December. Okay, but the problem is that there were some differences between the old version and the new. Firestorm wasn't a fan of clones. He didn't like when there were like five minor house units for every faction, for every minor house. So we had like Malister Swordsman, Malister Cavalry, Malister Crossbowman, Malister Halberdiers, Malister Pikeman, Malister Longbowman, Malister Bowman, Malister Swordsman, etc, etc. And all of them used the same body with different weapons, so they looked the same with a different weapon. He didn't like that system, and it's used in Fire and Blood as well. So he decided to remove a lot of the clones, and then he changed the ones that he kept. So he either gave them new textures, or he moved gear around. He took gear from other places and managed to create unique looking units instead of units that all looked the same. A good example of this is his wilding roster, where he moved different gear around and managed to create unique looking units instead of the same unit with different weapons. Alright, so Firestorm tried to make the mod more unique. Originally that was the idea. Wilhelm Ratio, the model creator of most of the Game of Thrones enhanced models, originally had planned to make all the units unique, with the exception of the regional units. But the thing is that it became too much for one person to do. I mean, some people can do it, like for example Andy Nephilim of Hyrule Total War, creator of Hyrule Total War. He did 30 rosters all by himself, but I guess not everyone has the free time or the passion to do that much, and instead decides to add weapons to the same model instead, because it's faster, it's easier, and you only need one model for all types of weapons instead of maybe 10 different or 7 different models. The models themselves take very long to rig and such. So if you can have one model with many weapons instead of 7 models with different weapons, then you save a lot of time by having just one. But of course it doesn't look as good, and isn't as interesting when you play the mod. Okay. So Firestorm aimed to make armies more unique. Okay, and he changed the names too, which is the problem, because I added some scripts and I copied my entries from the old version to the new. And the Golden Company Knights, they were named Golden Company Cavalry in his version. So I added 2 lines with Golden Company Knights in the scripts file. So when Darion Harris, the mercenary general of House Targaryen, when he spawns on turn 31, there are 2 entries with the wrong name. And that's why the game CTD or crashed the desktop immediately on turn 31, when it's the Targaryen's turn. So what I've been doing is that I've corrected that and started up the game, and I don't want to upload it because it takes some time to do. I don't want to upload it before testing it out. So we will let the game play for at least 71 turns. We have fast speed on. They will move fast on the map. We will follow the generals. We'll see what will happen on the map, but it will be a very speedy movement on the map. We won't have the slow speed on, it takes forever, but we will still be able to see what happens, but it will be fast. And then we will let the game continue until at least turn 72, when the final hero spawns. I believe it's Barristan Selmy spawns on between turn 71 and 72. But we will probably continue a bit longer than that, maybe to turn 150 or 200, so we can be sure that it's stable. Because in the past, when I played this, when I let the AI play, it continued for 800 to 1000 turns and no CD on the map. But because of my mistake with the scripts file, the game would crash immediately when Darius spawns on turn 31. And I don't want to upload the game if I'm not certain. There aren't any more such issues. I may have done more mistakes than one. So we will let it play at least for 72 turns. If it hasn't crashed by then I think it's safe to say that there are no more issues concerning entries. But we will still let it continue a bit after that to see that it's as stable as I expect it to be. Okay, so we have toggle FOV or toggle FOV enabled, so we can see the map. We are playing in hot seats, so we can place the faction we are playing under AI control. So we will use the AI the console command control T Timurids, which is the others. They are like a code name. They are based on the Timurids, alright, of the vanilla game. And this console command only works in hot seat. You can't use it in single player. Okay, so we'll take control over the Timurids or the others now, and we will see if the game will crash or not.
Nothing shall escape your notice in these lands, my lord.
Need to lower the sound too. Alright, so you can hear me. So we can see now that the mod is playing. The AI is controlling all the factions. So this is the new map created by Soul Games Inkle. And it's Firestorm's version of the mod. I've also worked on it. But he had already added all the factions to the map when I moved to this mod. I had already added all except the two that I mentioned, the three cities and the others. So I did pretty much the same work on the map, but on another version of the mod. Okay, but Firestorm also did all that work on units. He edited a lot of units to make new models that looked different from each other. As an example, the Wildling roster, he did a lot of heroes, he changed a lot of heroes. We got about 20 heroes or 30 heroes from the German Westeros team, and those heroes used, what should I say, they used different bodies, and they used heads that the Sco Sicario created. He got permission from the Sco Sicario to use the heads. Unlike the Germans, they didn't have permission to use the heads. So pretty much we stole the heads from the Germans. And then we got accused of stealing from the Sco Sicario. But after speaking to the Sco Sicario, he gave permission as long as we credited him. So we ended up with permission to use the heads, but they were on different bodies, very ugly bodies. I believe they were more book-based, maybe from Westeros. No, I don't think so. I think they were from some other mod, maybe Lord of the Rings or something. They weren't bad, but they didn't look like the show. The point is that we replaced or Firestorm replaced the bodies with the bodies of Viltim and Ratio, the creator of most of the models in this mod, Game of Thrones Enhanced. So Firestorm replaced the bodies of about 20 or 30 models and connected these new bodies from this mod with the heads that the Sco Sicario had made. Then we got 30 additional heads from P-Man. Those heads were also created by the Sco Sicario, but unlike the other heads that had been rigged by the German team and were ready to be implemented, the new 30 heads we got from P-Man were not rigged for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. So P-Man had rigged those heads himself. You can say that the Sco Sicario created the models, and that's a lot of work, but then P-Man rigged them, and that's also a lot of work. And then P-Man sent them to us, and some of them are unchanged and look exactly like they did when P-Man sent them to us. And some of the others have been altered, so they look different. They might have gotten more bodies from Game of Thrones Enhanced that have replaced old bodies from probably the German mod or other places. Okay, and sometimes P-Man used Game of Thrones Enhanced models, but Firestorm might have improved the model by adding a cape or something else to make it look a little different. Okay, and in some cases I believe P-Man can use the same models as the German mod, and we decided to change them to be more like the Game of Thrones enhanced models. We didn't like the bodies of the German mod. For example, Renly Baratheon has the same head but has a completely different body now. Okay, yeah, and I believe P-Man originally at least used the same body as the German mod, while we decided to replace it because it didn't fit with the style. Okay, so the game is going on. We are at turn 15, soon 16. You can see that there are some action. Renly, it's not named Renly, it's named Baratheon of Storm's End. So you could see that they were conquering. You can see the Night's Watch, the Lannisters, and others. Okay, so at on turn 31 the mod crashed because of the fault and try, two fault and tries. But we'll see if we have any other such issues now. Of course, people that have already downloaded the mod shouldn't need to download the entire mod again. I will upload a new version of the mod where I have corrected this issue. But I will also upload for a limited time the scripts file, which is just a few kilobit in size, so that anyone that already has the mod can just download that file and replace the file in his or her mods. He or she will need to remove the .rvm file in, I believe, the mod folder, and then in the world folder, and then in the base folder, the map folder, and then in the base folder, and then in the side of the base folder. So I believe in this case it's GOT, which stands for Game of Thrones. So GOT, and then data, and then maps, and then base, and inside of that folder is a .rwm file, and it will need to be deleted. Victory! After you have added the updated Desker scripts file. And the Desker scripts file should be in GOT, data, world, and maps, I believe, and then campaign, and then Imperial campaign, I believe, and then replace all the Desker scripts file. It's in the same folder where you have the Desker strat. Alright, so I messed up by just copy and pasting the same name for the Golden Company Cavalry, thinking Firestorm kept the old name, but he had named it Cavalry, and that's why it will crash, because I named it Knights. Okay, hopefully we have no more issues like that, but I need to make sure that we do not have that, because it's very annoying to have to first archive the file into a rare archive format. It takes some time, and then upload the mod to Google Drive, and then upload the mod again from Google Drive to moddb.com. It takes some time to do, probably at least 15 minutes or 20 minutes or something. But yeah, that's why I want to check this. We do not have any nasty surprises immediately after I have uploaded the file again. Okay, and also it could be interesting to see how the AI is doing on the map, because this map is new. I believe it was in a mod named A World of Ice and Fire in a few years ago, 2017 and 18, maybe 19. I believe they quit development in 2019, in early 2019. And I believe a few YouTubers played it. I believe Jackie Fish may have played it. It also had War of the Five Kings and used this map But they had way less factions. They didn't even have all the factions of the original Game of Thrones Enhanced. I believe factions such as House Renly and Stannis weren't in the game. Maybe Stannis, but not Renly. I'm sure Renly wasn't there. I'm not sure about Stannis, but he might not have been there. Okay, and then all the extra factions such as House Frey, House Bolton, and House Targaryen, the Wildlings, the Night's Watch, and a new faction from this version, and House Frey and House Bolton, they weren't in that mod either. So you can say it used this map but had a lot of factions missing. So this is the first time a mod is using Soul Games Inkles map with a lot of factions present on it. So you can say it's more packed with factions than it was in their original mod project. Okay. Soon we are at turn 31. I would be surprised if it did CTD. Then I might have forgotten to remove the .rvm file or something else. Because I have changed the descripts file. So I would be surprised. So on this turn it would crash. Because of Darion Harris. Have more spawns, we have the other spawning, we have the wildlings, and we have, but the wildlings I think spawned on turn 20, so it's fine, but the others and House Targaryen will have more spawns all the way up to turn 51 for the others, and then we have Barristan Selmy on turn 71 or 72, so at least until then. There could be issues if I have typed wrongly a name in the spawning armies, because the Golden Company Knight's name wasn't in any of the files of Firestorm's version, so the game couldn't find the text and that's why it crashed. When you add a unit you need to have the name in certain files. If the name isn't there the game can't find the unit, and then it can't read the unit, and if it can't read the unit, the game will crash. Okay. That's a shame, because I believe, last I checked, 119 people had downloaded this mod. I uploaded it yesterday in the morning. So it's been available for almost a day. Okay, and it's sad because I were actually bragging that it's 100% stable on the map, and then they crashed on turn 31. when thinking about how unstable the old version is, I'm afraid when that happens, they think this is just another unstable version again. So it's a shame that they got that impression. That's why I need to replace it as soon as possible. Also, I had forgotten to replace the new Robb Stark hero model with the model that P-Man added and rigged. Because P-Man rigged a lot of cool new models, both for agents and for battle models. But he said that, and that's understandable, that he wanted most of the models to be unique to Fire and Blood for now. So for example, he wants to at least release his mod and have it out for a while before he wants to share those models. But he still shared a lot of strat models, generals and cities. So he got access to all his strat model cities, but it's very hard to add strat model cities because If one city shares the same text with another, then both will use the same city. So if you want all the cities to look unique, you need to find unique entries in text, which is very annoying to do. But it's easier if you have 30 factions like Peeman has in Fire and Blood. Then it's easier, because the more factions you have, the more combinations you can do. If you have only 17 if you have only 17 factions like in Game of Thrones Enhanced, it's much harder to utilize all those city models. So what I did was that I replaced all of the ones that we already had implemented, because Firestorm had added a bunch of new strat models from different places, and I decided to replace most of them, all of them actually, with the exception of some old ones by Inarus that already were in this mod. He couldn't use his new ones because he didn't want me to use them, and with modding, if you use someone else's assets without permission, then not only can you lose your like status and titles etc. on Total War Center, but you can also lose your on modibay.com, they can remove all your mods if you steal assets. So that's why I'm worried. I mean, I'm of the opinion that people should share, and I'm also not the type that would care much about free content being shared, but if I risk losing like all my work that I've done in recent years, then I have a reason to follow the rules, I guess. But anyway, the point is that Inarus was the original creator of Game of Thrones Enhanced, which was an art mod for Westeros Total War, the 53 Alpha, released in 2011. He released an art mod in 2011 too, and 12 and 13 and 14. Art mod, as in he added custom voices, he added a music add-on, he added scripts, he added a map, he added loading screens, unit cards, and added UI, user interface, and a lot of other stuff. And the family members and such of the original versions of Game of Thrones Enhanced, and he also made unique strat models for Winterfell, Storm's End, Highgarden, King's Landing, and Pike, and Moat Cailin, and maybe something else. And because the mod already used those, we could use them, but he made new ones for Soul Games Inkle and Parafix. They were working on this A World of Ice and Fire mod, and he made new ones for them. And that mod used this map, so when I got permission from Soul Games Inkle to use the map, I also got access to those models. He had new ones for Castle Rock and Lannisport, and a new Storm's End model, I believe. And he had a Dreadfort model too. And the thing is that you could argue that it might be okay to use them in this mod, because this is Game of Thrones Enhanced, the same mod that he started years ago, and also the old models he made are already in the mod. And it's a submod of Westeros too, but me and Will Timaratio, the guy who created pretty much 95% of the models in the mod, we started to work on Game of Thrones Enhanced in 2016 during the summer, back when the mod had art, the sound, the music, but and the scripts and the map, but still used vanilla models and an older system of gameplay, vanilla system. The game was more like Vanilla Medieval 2 in how it played. Okay, and Viltima Ratio posted a few models of Lannisters and Starks in the forum at Total War Center, the Westeros forum. And after that I joined him and we helped each other, and he made models and I coded them into the mod. He also coded some of them into the mod, but I did a lot of gameplay too, and I did unit cards and such, but mostly I did coding. But I did quite a few unit cards and added new factions and such, but all the models were made and the textures were made by Viltima Radio. So you can say that we continued the mod. Innarus had in 2014, I believe, asked for modelers. They wanted someone with the skills to help them make models based on the TV show, because the art mod was a Game of Thrones TV show mod. They wanted the mod to be as close to the TV show as possible, as opposed to the other Westeros mods that were all based on the books. So the Game of Thrones Enhanced mod was the only Game of Thrones mod that was based on the show, while everything else was based on the books. And Innarus and his team had asked for a modeler, but none was around back when they did that. And in 2016, Viltima Ratio read that and started to make models. But by that time, Innarus and the others had long since left the modding scene. And I joined with Viltima Ratio to help him, because he said that he wanted to focus only on creating models, but because he had none to work with, he had to do more than just create models. He needed to do the coding and the unit cards and everything else, gameplay and such, and that's why he asked for help, and I'm the guy that joined him in helping him so that he could focus on creating models while I did everything else pretty much. But he also did some other stuff like banners, symbols, etc. Of the factions. Okay, and he did the unit cards of most of the models. I did some of them, but he did the majority. And in this version that Firestorm has made, he has replaced probably all of my unit cards, because he wanted all of them to have the same style, and I believe Viltima Ratio's style is slightly different from mine, so yeah. Okay, but the point is that we continued Innarus's old mod, and that's why we got his old stuff, but then since then, a lot of the stuff that used to be in the mod has been replaced. I mean, in the latest version, for example, we do not have the same map anymore. And previously, we replaced the loading screens. We replaced all the vanilla models, because the original mod had Vanilla Medieval 2 models. And then I believe they added vanilla models with some reskins, so they had different colors than the vanilla game, but were still vanilla models. So you can say that the game wasn't good looking in battle before Viltima Ratio created these cool models. Of course, the news about Game of Thrones Enhanced reached the ears of Radbud and Innarus in 2017, I believe. They were positive about us working with it back then, so they gave permission for us to continue the mod and such, gave me permission to do it. But then, because I were easily irritated in the forum, and because I answered some fans in a rude manner. Because when I released, I believe, Game of Thrones 3.7, I believe, or 3.8, and I released those mods, there were a fan that immediately demanded new stuff immediately after I just released it, and I think I was kind of rude in my answer, and the Innerus didn't like that, so that's when he started to dislike me and wanted to withdraw the permission for me to work on the mod, and things didn't get better when I entered into a cooperation with Solgames Inkel and Parafix. The plan was to move Solgames Inkel's map to Game of Thrones Enhanced, and enhance this mod with his map, or move the models of Game of Thrones Enhanced to their mod. And in the end, it was decided that I would join them and move the models there. But due to being tired after working with, I believe I worked with Warcraft Total War demo during the spring of 2017, I worked with Game of Thrones constantly during the spring of 2017, and I believe I worked on something else too, maybe Wrath of the Norsemen, I believe. Anyway, I was tired of modding, so I didn't keep didn't keep my word. I promised to add all of the rosters to their mod, but the only roster I added was Targaryen, House Targaryen, and the rest weren't added, so they got pissed and threw me out of the team. And then there were some problems about units and such, because I tried to withdraw them and it wasn't possible and such. It wasn't my units, but I had permission from Viltimaratio as his partner to find a new map for them, so I had found their project as the new map, but then things escalated and I got kind of fired from the team, and all of a sudden I didn't want them to have the models, but I believe Gigantus ruled against me and said that they could keep them, so all of a sudden there were two mods with these models. The World of Ice and Fire mod and Game of Thrones Enhanced. Then later, I believe, some games Inkel and Parafix had some problems in their cooperation, and Parafix went his own way and created another mod named Ice and Fire Total War, and it is using these models too, so all of a sudden there were three mods with the models instead of just Game of Thrones Enhanced. But the World of Ice and Fire mod was closed or discontinued in 2019, but I believe Jackie Fish had played it on YouTube, and that's what I was saying, that the mod had this map with some different regions, because I believe Firestorm has removed some regions that didn't fit the time or era, because the original level of Ice and Fire mod had some factions that aren't in this mod, for example the Brothers Without Banners, and I believe it was the Brothers Without Banners, and maybe even the Priest faction in King's Landing, don't remember the name. Okay, and they had some regions. We didn't need those regions because those factions are not factions in this version. Instead, we have others like the Wildlings and the Night's Watch and such that weren't in their version. So that's why some regions were removed and some regions were added, but it's the same map and with a lot more factions on it. Okay. So while Jack Fish might have played on the map before. He hasn't. He has probably not played with this version, which, and it's more grand in scale. Okay, so I managed to reach a deal with Soul Games Inkel in May 2019, where he allowed me to use his map in Game of Thrones Enhanced, and with that map followed Inarus's new models, because Inarus had a deal with Parafix and Soul Games Inkel to let them use his strat models, the new ones that he created in 2019, use them in the World of Ice and Fire mod. So that's why this map came with Inarus's new models for Castle of the Rock and Lannisport, but he didn't want me to use them, so I had no choice but to remove them, because otherwise I risk my other mods. But the weird thing is that indirectly he is preventing his original mod, Game of Thrones Enhanced, from using his new models, which is kind of weird. And there are people who has said that it might be okay to use them, because if you look at it, you can see that Inarus is actually the creator of this mod, the original version of this mod, and he is the creator of those models. And it's weird that we can't use his models in his own mod. But, well, I didn't want to take any risks, you know. But I also agree with that we should be able to use his strat models in a mod that was his mod from the beginning. It's just that this version has seen a lot of work from me and from Will Team Aratio and from others as well. If you removed all my work and all Will Team Aratio's work, then it would just be vanilla models and vanilla gameplay, and yeah, but it would still have, and it would have the old small map, but it would still have Inarus's cool strat models on the map, and it would have the scripts, the sounds, music, and the art. So I say it would still look pretty good when it comes to UI and art and such, and it would sound good too, but in battle it wouldn't be good with vanilla models. And the gameplay, as I said, I spent almost the entire spring 2017 working on the gameplay of this mod. I spent some time on Warcraft 2, but we were a team with Warcraft Total War. We were six people, so I didn't do everything there. And so most of my time were spent on this one, the old one, the 4.5 one. Okay, so in essence, we are not allowed to use the Casterly Rock and the Lannisport strat models made by Inarus in a mod originally created by Inarus. It's just a little funny to me. But I don't want to risk any other mods. But you can say that the map had the right to use them, because Inarus made them for this map. The only problem is that he made them for Soul Games Inkel's project, A World of Ice and Fire, and not for Game of Thrones Enhanced. But Game of Thrones Enhanced is, as I said, his old project, so it's weird that he wouldn't allow his new models to be used in his old project, but that's just my opinion. But anyway, we can do without them. It's just that this map looked better with the Castle of Rock model and the Lannisport model, because Inarus did a very good job on the models. He is good at doing strat models. I thought they fit perfectly, but as I said, I don't want to risk entire mods for a strat model. That's not worth it. Okay, but in the end, there is nothing stopping individuals from using them. So if you have the ability to mod, you can mod it in yourself. I believe the rules are that you can use anything for private use, but that will require you to do the modding yourself. In other words, I could take anything I want from any mod and implement to any mod, and then I can play it for my own enjoyment. So if I wanted assets that I do not have permission for, I could still take them and implement them and then play the game. But it requires that I know how to implement them, so I need to be a modder to do it. So someone that can't mod wouldn't be able to do it and would need to learn how to mod first. But that means that I could, for example, re-implement his models, and I could use any model from P-Man's mod that he isn't giving permission for, and then I could play it myself. But I do not have the right to upload the mod with those assets and make it public for others. So I can't share a mod with assets that I do not have permission for, but I can use it myself for private use. So if Inarus or anyone else do not want to share a certain model with a certain mod because they dislike the modder that is working on it, then that won't really succeed well, because if I'm ever gonna play this mod, I could just re-implement those models and play it with those models. He's not preventing me from using the models, because I can just take them, implement them and play. He is preventing the players, you guys, playing the mod from having the models in the game. So it's in essence the only result of not giving permission is that the players of the mod will not have those wonderful models to look at, because I am not at all affected by that, because I know how to mod. I can make a personal mod where I include everything that I want from any Game of Thrones mod, I mean, and then I can play that. He isn't preventing me from using the models, that's what I'm saying. If the goal is to prevent Mr. Nygren from using his models, then he has failed, because I will be able to just use anything that I want. He can't stop me. I can just download the stuff and implement them, and then I play. But he is succeeding in preventing everyone else from using the models, because I can't make it public with those assets. So the only result of not giving permission is that players won't be able to use the models, which is a shame, especially since they were made for this map too. Just not for this mod, but that just makes it kinda funny or ironic, because this mod is Game of Thrones Enhanced, and Inarus is the creator of Game of Thrones Enhanced originally. He is the user that created the moddable page for Game of Thrones Enhanced too. So the point I'm saying is that those models, in my opinion, should be in this mod, and it would just look better, and those models, just like this mod, are work of art that Inarus has spent time on. It's kinda sad that they can't be enjoyed. It seems like a waste to make them if they aren't used. I know that P-Man is using them in Fire and Blood too, but they were made for this map. So, if the reason is, like I believe, that he doesn't want me to use it because he has problem with me, because I had a problem with Parafix, and he is probably a friend of Parafix, but he is a friend of Solgames Inkel too, and I do not have any problems with Solgames Inkel since 2019, so otherwise he wouldn't have given me permission for the map. Okay, but I believe he just don't want me to use it, but as I said, I can use it if I want. So this refusal to give permission to use the models in this mod is only hurting the players. It's not hurting me. Of course it's hurting the mod too, because the mod looks less beautiful without those models, and that's the point. I would want them in the mod because they make the mod, the map look more beautiful, more like the show, which was the original plan of his, to make a mod that looks like the show. So by not being able to use them, we still have those vanilla cities, and that looks kinda meh in comparison. So all I'm saying is that the mod would benefit from using those models, and the players would benefit from having them too, so they don't have to look at vanilla stuff. But me personally, I can use them in a private mod, so I mean, it's the mod that is suffering, and the players. I can still make a let's play in the future where I have included everything I find anywhere. I can pretty much rob any place that I want of any model and implement to a private mod, and then I can start a let's play. Then I will play on YouTube with a version of the mod that has a lot of assets that I do not have permission for, because I do not need permission to use it privately. The permissions are only if you make them public. So, as I said, the only one losing out is the player and the mod itself. Okay, so we are at turn 130 now. So the game hasn't crashed, very good. The wars are going on, the others have conquered a lot in the north. They've taken most of the areas from the wildlings, and also the Night's Watch are being pressed from two sides. They are being pressed by the Starks too. Seems they have a war with the Starks. And the House Targaryen is aggressive in Essos too, has conquered a lot of areas there. We can see that House Bolton or Tully, I believe it's Tully, are still pretty strong in the center of Westeros there. Lannisters are still strong. Tully or Bolton has conquered a Baratheon of King's Landing, which is the Joffrey faction. Renly is still around. This weaker. Martells and House Tyrell has taken areas from them. House Bolton is still as strong as they were in the past in the north. That's because they are allied with Starks. And the alliance probably is still active. Okay, the Night's Watch have some areas beyond the wall, but has lost 2 out of 3 areas in the wall, I believe, to the Starks. The Free Cities of Essos are holding the upper part of Essos, and some Isles, or Ayer. I have a hard time pronouncing that. Okay, Isles, or Ayers. I say Isles, sorry. I like it's written. Anyway, we have Martell, they moved up to Renly lands, I believe. So Lannisters are strong, but they managed to somehow be defeated in the east, or east or whatever. So has Tully or has Bolton have managed to kill off Joffrey? I believe the faction leaders might have been killed. Joffrey and Tommen might have been killed. Maybe even Tyrion. all of them probably needs to die for the faction to be destroyed. Okay, so we are at turn 139 now. I'm happy with this. I think it's stable. We could let it go on until turn 200 or something, but I also forgot to replace the Robb Stark model in this mod with the one that Peeman made that is superior, because he rigged a Robb Stark model from the official game, just like the Daenerys Stormborn model is also from the official game, I believe the mobile game or the internet game. I believe Winter's Coming or something else. One of the games were named that. There were two games. Okay, so the Robb Stark model is very good. It looks like in the show. And unlike this one that is in this mod currently, it has the cape and all that cool gear. I believe the body is better. I believe the heads are good in both versions. It's just the body is used already by Rickon Stark and Bran Stark and Jon Stark, custom battle only, and Eddard Stark, which is also a custom battle only character. But I think it's enough that Rickon Stark and Bran Stark are using that body in the campaign. And I think we could use something else for Robb Stark. It was originally intended for Robb Stark, but the one that Peeman made is exactly like the one from the show, so because it's photocorrect. It's not just the head, it's the body too that is correct. So I will probably replace that hero before uploading the mod, so you will have a better Robb Stark in battle. Peeman also has a Robb Stark hero that he wasn't going to add his mods, he wanted me to add it, but I don't really know how to add you know, custom hero strat models. I read about it, but I've forgotten about it. I will need to read up on it, but he offered to do it for me, but I don't know how it is with that now. That was some time ago. Anyway, it would be great to have Robb Stark with a Robb model on the map. Maybe he will help me with that in the future, or maybe I will look it up myself and do it, but I don't think I will spend time on that now. But we will add the battle model. Okay. So we'll add two models from actual official games, Robb Stark and Daenerys Stormborn. I believe also we had Jon Snow too. We will get a new Jon in custom battle, the one that is named Jon Stark and added to House Stark. Okay, but I wasn't allowed to add the Giants or the new dragons. They are only available to Fire and Blood for now. Otherwise I could probably have wanted those. I'm not sure, because the mammoths I am using are very big and look very good, so I mean, his are exactly like the show ones, but they are smaller, and I still think the ones from Warhammer Altcut are really good. After I remove the gear, the Chaos gear and the Norskan gear, etc., they look very good. But of course, it would be more show correct to have the ones from Fire and Blood. But as I said, they were smaller, and that is a minus. Otherwise they are pretty cool, because they are from the show. So the Giants too were smaller, but I would probably prefer those Giants over the Giants from Warhammer, but who knows. Maybe he will give permission for those at a later date, maybe. And the dragon, that's the one that would be really cool, because I don't really think the dragons from Warhammer, they don't really look, they look so weird. They fit in Warhammer, but they are too long, I think, too wide, like they are too long, but kind of weird looking. I think the dragons from the show would look better. I even think that the dragons from Warcraft would look better, but I didn't want to use the proto-drakes from Warcraft that look kind of similar to the show dragons. But the reason I don't want to use them is because they will crash the game unless you use the engine overhaul project tool. If you use that tool, they will work fine. I was going to use that tool in Game of Thrones Enhanced, by the way. Add Berserker ability to some units and make sure we could use all the giant dragons, etc. on Windows 10 computers, but I realized that there are some bugs with the engine overhaul project tool. Riders are kinda glitched when they die and when they move to the side and such. And certain units like war wagons are having a more serious issue. They have invisible riders. Okay, so that's why I'm avoiding the program if I don't have to use it. That's why I wanted to release it like a normal mod and see if people with Windows 10 have CD crash to desktop in battles when using the dragons, the giants, or the mammoths. But I believe the dragons and the mammoths should be fine, because the creator of Warhammer Alt Cut has done a good job on the his units, the giant units in his mod, so they will probably not crash on Windows 10. He has managed to rig them correctly, but the old giants from Call of Warhammer that we got from Fire and Blood, and which Fire and Blood got from the German mod, the German Westeros mod, I believe that model could be a cause of crash to desktop on Windows 10. I don't know for sure, so that's what we'll need to find out. But if I find that I need to use the tool, then I will probably replace the Warhammer dragons, or probably not, because the Warhammer dragons have the correct looks. They have not looks, they have the correct colors, I mean pigment skin them, and they look kinda good, the skins. But if I take dragons from Warcraft, we would need new skins, so that's a problem. Of course, the dragons in Fire and Blood, they are actual models from official games, so those models are superior to anything from Warcraft and Warhammer. But we do not have permission for them at this stage. Maybe in a few months, maybe we get permission for them, I don't know. Other models I want is of course the princess models. But I believe I have the same problem there. If I wanted to replace, for example, Sansa Stark, it's not enough to know how to replace the princess models. So I could easily replace the generic models, that's no problem, but replacing Sansa and adding Arya, etc. I believe that's the same procedure as adding Robb Stark as his own custom strat model. And I don't know how to do that. I will need to read up on such things. I did in the past, but no, I can't really remember it for too long. If time goes by, if enough time passes by, I don't remember exactly what I had read all those months ago anyway. Okay. So you are at turn 180 and no CD, no crash to desktop. Pastor Garion has taken almost all of S's. And House Tyrell are pushing House Martell back. House Bolton or House Tully have taken quite a few areas and have moved down to areas held by Renly previously. Renly is still not defeated. They've taken areas that was held by Stannis in the past. The Lannisters are still strong. Starks are the strongest in Westeros, they have the largest area. House Arryn have their entire starting area, they haven't done much, they are probably passive, like they should be. believe the very detailed terrain prevents us Aaron from doing much. I think that's good. Solo Games Inc. did a great job on House Aaron and their starting location, etc. They never really do much. Yeah, just like in lore. Okay, House Bolton have their starting areas left. By the way, I want to see if Bolton's or House Tully are in the game. Problem is, we need to be fast to move down there. Can also see that House Frey is still alive. Night's Watch is still alive. House Greyjoy still has Mount Cailin and the area next to it. But has lost other areas in the north. They have their Iron Isles, Iron Isles of course. Okay. So the camera is following you. It's zooming closer, but I think it's House Tully that is holding all these areas. Dragonstone is rebel held. It's House Tully. All right, we are at turn 190. We will end it at turn 201. Then we know that it's stable. Most people will not play more than maybe 100 turns, 150 turns, 170 turns, 200 turns. The most maybe someone would play 300 turns. And that's extreme. If it doesn't crash for 200 turns, then I'm happy. I wasn't happy when I found out that it crashed on turn 31. After bragging that it would was 100% stable. And it is probably 100% stable, if I do not make mistakes, like adding the wrong text to a file. Okay. It doesn't have any of the old bugs that the old version had. It doesn't CTD for no reason. Well, I'm sure there are reasons, but I don't know what reasons. I tried to fix the old bugs, but it was kind of impossible. We even I did a lot of work during the spring of 2017, and I remade all of that during the summer because of a CTD, and it seemed to work. And then when I finally reached the same point in the modding, it became useless and unstable. So that old version of the mod really had some issues at the core, some bugs that couldn't be fixed. It was broken, and we really needed a new base for the mod, a different mod as a base, without any of the issues or bugs. And I believe this is it. The only reason it crashed was because I didn't know that the model had a new name. I used the old name. That's entirely on me. It's not the mod's fault. I believe the reason the old version crashed a lot and you needed to start custom battles first before entering the map, etc. It's because of some mod issue, an issue within the mod, and it's almost impossible to know what it is. And you weren't there at the start. If you have modded a mod from beginning to end, then you can easily know where you, like, if it's stable and all of a sudden you end up with a CTD, then you can figure out the reason, because you have kept track of what you have been doing up to that point. But if you continue someone else's mod and it has a lot of issues already, then it's impossible to know the cause behind those issues and impossible to fix. And the only way to fix it is probably to start all over and remake the mod on a different base. like we did here, like Firestorm did. But I also did a lot of work on the mod. I coded some stuff in the mod. I added all the unique bodyguards to the mod. He had made it so that most of the heroes used the same bodyguard. He added all the unique ones from Custom Battle to the campaign. In most mods you can do that by placing the unit at the top in the disk strat file. If it's a cavalry unit it will be picked automatically, and if it's not a cavalry unit it will be picked automatically if there are no cavalry units in the army. But it didn't work in this mod for some reason. Very odd, because it worked in Warcraft, it worked in the old Game of Thrones mod, it worked in Hyrule, and it worked in pretty much all mods I worked on, but it didn't work in this one. So I had to give the unit general unit attribute. So now they are their bodyguards, but that meant I had to add no custom entries in the disk strat, quite a few of them. So they are taking up slots from the EDU, but we, Firestorm, said that he isn't the type that wants to fill out the unit slots anyway. So you can have 500 units in total in Medieval Total War, and if you have heroes like that, they steal slots from units. If you remove the heroes, you could have units in their place, but Firestorm isn't a fan of just adding more units for the sake of adding more units. He prefers having fewer or less units over having a bunch of clones. So instead of having 7 or 5 clones with different weapons, he prefers to have fewer units but with unique looks instead. Of course, if we had 500 entirely unique models, then he could probably think that's better than having 500 units that look the same, but I still think he is of the opinion that there is no need to use all the unit slots. So I think it won't be a problem that I used maybe 30 slots on heroes that are only available in the campaign. Okay. We are on turn 230 now. So let's control the Timurids again. We get the start, and then we will wait. We will check the map. We want to see what's happened. So we are back on the Timurid turn, or the others' turn. We can see that the others have conquered some areas. They've gone down and conquered Ice River Cannibals camp from the wildlings, and the Frozen Shore tribes have been conquered too. Then they have conquered, no, they moved down here, they have areas down here, and we can see that they've spawned with their great army, including undead giants. They conquered the cave dwellers settlement. The wildlings are still holding Tense Hold, it's their capital. They are holding North Grove as well. So they only have two regions. The Night's Watch have taken the Feast of the First Men, or whatever it's named, yeah. And they have taken Hardhome. No, the Starks have gone and taken it from the Night's Watch, I believe. How Stark has been fighting a war against the Night's Watch, despite them being allied at the start of the game. As Bolton is still holding Carhold, the Dread Fort, and Ramsgate. And they have probably taken Widow's Watch, unless they had that too from the start. They may have had that. Okay, so we have White Harbor here with a new model. All the princesses here are vanilla. I hope to replace them with Peemans in the future. Okay. This model is of course one of Peemans. He allowed us to use the strat model cities, but not the strat model units or giants. I mean agents. he allowed us to use the generals too because they were older. Okay, and like this model here, it's the old Winterfell. I believe Inarus made this in 2012 or something, or 14, 13 maybe, so it was already in the mod. But he made a new one for this map that I had to replace with the old one due to permission issues. And then we have what about factions over here? Ah, so the Greyjoys are still holding these areas. Freys are still around holding the twins. Tullys are very strong. I won the war against Joffrey and taking King's Landing, so they are holding the Iron Throne. So Edmure, King Edmure, King's Landing, okay. Unless he's dead and there is another leader now. Maybe Brynden Tully or someone else. Less significant. We have the Greyjoys, of course, their ISILs are never attacked, probably, by the AI. They might need the scripted invasions to be attacked. Okay, we have House Tyrell. They have started to invade the Martells. The Martells are losing big time. And we had a rebel army up here too. Degos Vaith, probably a random name. So has Martellus taken an ISIL here too? We have Darion Harris with a huge army here. The general that would crash previously, now he doesn't. Humphrey Stone, rebel general. I see that the Free Cities are still around, they are still holding Tyrosh. And they are holding this area too. Lys. Astorgarian has taken Kusar Noi. Started with this area, Vase Croyane. Taken Myr from the Free Cities of Essos. And he had some new random generals here, Kyle Targaryen and Joset Brashamas. Taken Nysar from the rebels, I believe, or the Free Cities. Free Cities are still holding their capital of Pentos. We have some rebels. Stogarian is holding Goyandrohe too. Seems to be one unit holding it, probably one of the dragons. They're taking Andalus as well. Maybe the two other dragons. And then we have Braavos here. Held by the Free Cities. Arryns are still holding their entire realm. I haven't done much in the war. As Renly is smaller than at the start, but they are still around and they're strong, and they've taken areas from Hastanis. These two areas, Sharp Point and Stone Dance. Well, Driftmark, Dragonstone, and Claw Isle have fallen to rebels. Maybe they killed Stannis and they got Sievert and killed off the faction. So the Seduce turned rebel. And then they took those areas. Okay, I think we're done. Then there's a rebel area here. Yeah, I think we're done. Alright, thanks for watching. I will make a video later about the features of the mod and such that I will include for the article that I'm gonna write. But I will probably try to finish the music add-on first. So this mod is going to have the same music add-on as the old version, where you get the files all set up. So if you buy the albums of the official soundtracks of season 1, 2, 3, or maybe possibly even season 4, 5, 6, and 7, then you can have that music play on the map and in battles. But you need to get the music yourself, either by buying the music or by getting it by other means. Okay, so it's up to the player to get the music, but we will provide the files. So if you own the music, and it doesn't matter how you got it, as long as it's on your computer, then you can just add it to the mod, and the music will play instead of the vanilla music, because this mod has vanilla music on the map and in battle. Well, it has Game of Thrones music only in the intro videos and scripted videos, and in the main menu, because the main menu is an old FMV. Okay, from the show, I believe, back when they asked, "Are you a Stark or are you?" They made a mashup of different scenes with some good music, but the problem is that the campaign and the battles have vanilla music, which is good for Let's Players that are earning money. They don't want official music, because then the videos will get demonetized. Okay, thanks for watching. I will upload this to YouTube soon after this. I will need to process it first, of course. And the mod will be re-uploaded now. I will replace that Rob Stark hero model. And after that I will re-upload it. Okay, see ya. Bye.